And the number one worst SpongeBob episode is Yours, Mine, and Mine. Why do I hate this episode even worse than One Course Meal? Because unlike One Course Meal, this episode is just way too mean-spirited. I mean, the mean-spirited in the last episode was mean-spirited, but when it comes to non-suicide things in this episode, that makes this episode even worse than One Course Meal. Because the development of this episode and the One Course Meal episode are completely different. I mean, there are different types of mean-spirited that I really hate. People committing suicide and people killing off someone. But what this episode does is being mean. Very, very mean and very unacceptable. And it completely changes people. It really does. This is a Patrick a Jerk episode, but in my opinion, one of the worst. Really one of the worst. He wants to have a Krabby Patty at the Krusty Krab, but he doesn't have any money, and SpongeBob decides to pay for it. Patrick does this. Patrick takes SpongeBob's wallet out of his pocket, and he calls it sharing. No, that's stealing. Oh my god. And when SpongeBob gives the meal to Patrick, he eats all of it and he's upset that it didn't came with a toy, so he wants his money back. That's SpongeBob's money. And when Mr. Krabs hears that Patrick is upset that he did get a toy, he makes a toy that SpongeBob pays as well, with his money for real. But Patrick interferes with SpongeBob's excitement and actually says that it's our toy in the meaning of sharing. No. You ate all of SpongeBob's meals. You don't deserve a toy. You really don't. Seriously. Ugh. Anyway, SpongeBob gives the toy to Patrick and Patrick just refused to share it at all. Oh my god. This is just gonna get even more worse. In fact, it just makes Patrick more of a hateable friend than ever. Why? Because most of this episode is just Patrick having a toy 95% of the time without SpongeBob even touching it. Oh my god. Oh my god is what this episode is about. No, what this show is about. When Patrick says that SpongeBob might get it tomorrow, you just really want to punch him in the face because you know he's not going to keep that promise. Patrick is so selfish in the worst way possible. He really is. And when SpongeBob tells Patrick to get out of his house, he did, but Patrick still refused to share. Oh my god, Patrick is so a jerk in this episode. I mean, he's a dickhole. A combination of an asshole and a dick. Because those two words combined makes him a jerk and an idiot. Ugh. I really hate Patrick a lot. He's so bad. And when they get to Sandy's house, she says that it's all about sharing, but SpongeBob knows about sharing, but Patrick doesn't. He really doesn't. He doesn't understand sharing at all in this episode. And then after that, they still fight over it until they get to the Krusty Krab, and then Patrick eats it. This crosses the line. And when Mr. Krabs finds out about this, they make two toys for everyone because apparently it's a big hit. And then when Patrick says that it's on him, you really think he's gonna use his money? Nope. You know what he does? He steals SpongeBob's wallet, and then SpongeBob says, Patrick, that's my wallet. And then Patrick says, have you learned nothing about sharing? You, Patrick, you learn nothing about sharing at all in this episode. SpongeBob does know what sharing is. Let me talk about why this is number one on this list and why this is worse than One Course Meal. Unlike One Course Meal, children doesn't understand what suicide means. And even if this is very inappropriate to kids to see this, but they just don't understand it yet. But unlike this episode, yours, mine, and mine, they are just literally showing people that you should never share in real life. I mean, I don't like sharing, but that's something you have to deal with. To be with a friend who is actually a friend. And most of this episode is just staying away from your best friend, so-called best friend, just to share with a toy who the person just paid his money with just to use it. And you know why I despise this episode even more than One Course Meal? Because unlike One Course Meal's mean-spirited, this mean-spirited is worse in a different type. Throughout the show, there is never any win to the innocence in this show. That's what the post-movie episodes really tick me off, is because of how mean-spirited it is. Unlike the Squid with Torture Points, Patrick's A Jerk episodes, and Mr. Krabs being greedy, the mean-spirited is ridiculous in the show. In the earlier seasons, there was no mean-spirited at all, except if you count Squidward, but he got his comeuppance the right way. There's just no escaping from mean-spirited in this show, and that's just completely insurmountable. Quote from the Nostalgia Critic. Anyway, I pretty much knew that that was the biggest problem in modern SpongeBob, all because of Cool Cat and his friend. You should really check out his top 10 biggest problems with modern SpongeBob, because you pretty much know that mean-spirited is what's wrong, and it's completely scarring people for life. Anyway, that's my top 25 list, and here's my final thoughts on SpongeBob. Like I said, this show should have ended after the first movie. Say all you want about maybe the newer episodes of season 10, but at this point, post-movie SpongeBob has been going on for almost 12 years. And there's really nothing special about it, except with some good episodes. But here's the thing, would you rather watch some of the good post-movie episodes over the very god-awful episodes of SpongeBob? I mean, you had to be very insane to still be a SpongeBob fan because of stuff like this. I mean, if the bad episodes were just plain bad episodes like Cartoon, Children Bad, then it would be acceptable. But no. The fact that Nickelodeon really doesn't care that Steven Hillenburg wants to end the show just after the movie and just keep going because the money jokes just really proves that they literally don't care about anything in the world. They don't care about making the network great. They don't care about entertaining people. They really just want to continue the program with crap. Pure crap. And that's just sick. This is why I prefer SpongeBob ending after the first movie. Even though when the post-movie SpongeBob episode started, there were some good cartoons and Nickelodeon was still good during that time, but probably after the release of Attack of the Power of Juju, the TV show, things have been just getting downhill as possible. And it just gets really worse when they change the logo and the look. Especially making deals with DreamWorks on making cartoons. Ugh. Yes, we won't be able to have the second movie, but still, that's not all worth it after everything. Ugh. My God. I'm honestly getting tired from these writers' crap all the time. Even when Steven Hillenburg is back on the job, doesn't make this show to go on. I expected this show to at least end after the first movie. Anyway, I'm Lonely Fanboy Flay here, and this was my top 25 worst SpongeBob episodes. Ugh. What's next for me? To be fair, I'm only going to review one episode. And hopefully in 2017, I hopefully get a great year on YouTube. Anyway, I'm Lonely Fanboy Flay here, and I need a long week of rest after watching these episodes. I really do. See you next time.